This week on 1010 XL Showdown, we debate which was better in sports, then or now.
Then or now, let's see. Old guy, young guy. You guess which way we're going to go.
Well, here's what we're going to do. We're going to talk about not only which teams were better, which players were better, when were the sports better, then or now. It's coming up right after this on 1010 XL Showdown.
I'm ready to bring the pain.
Bear Bryant built the SEC. Have you lost your mind? Michael Jordan is the greatest of all time.
Mike, it's time for me to school you.
If you're talking school, it must be old school. I think you need your head in there.
Greatest of all time, you've got to be joking.
You're just sucking up to those fans.
Wrong.
You're wrong.
Just hear me out.
That's crazy.
You can't really believe he's the best.
The man is a legend.
We do welcome you to the program where we talk about when was sports better, then or now. Frank Frangie, Mike Dempsey, and I'm going first. Old guy gets to go first on this.
Go right ahead.
Let's start with the National Football League, Mike. I think the play is better now. The players are better now. The sport was better then. You know why? Because they had high-top black cleats and grass and dirt and mud, and it was football. And it wasn't about bling. I know you're a big bling guy. You've always been a bling guy.
I'm all about
bling. You are a bling guy. It wasn't about the bling then. It was, and I think people cared about teams more than they did players. It was about civic pride and city pride. I don't think that matters anymore. I think it's all about bling and players and who can get the best endorsement deals. The NFL was better before than it is now.
Where did I? Here's the memo. Apparently, you're the one who didn't get it, okay? Unprecedented popularity for a sports league. There's the memo
is
from the National
memo?
Football
League. Is this the memo?
That's
I
the official
thought that was
memo
the, looks
right
like
there.
The memo, yeah.
Look, come on, you admitted better play now. Okay, the popularity's through the roof. The players of now are just a better-conditioned athlete. The NFL is so popular on so many levels. And you know what? Part of it is parity. Different teams can win in today's modern age, and I think you had more of a dynasty aspect. Although we've had the New England Patriots, they've kind of defied the trend of late to have different teams pop up, and that just kind of shows how great they are. I think the NFL is wide open. So many teams feel like their team has a chance, so many fan bases. I just think the NFL is off the charts. It's probably the most successful league at this moment of any sports league in history.
Why didn't it seem like there were so many negative stories before? And I know there's more news media than there's ever been. There's 24-hour sports channels. But it just seems there's so much negativity around the league. I know the league is a great marketing tool, and Pete Rozelle and Paul Tagliabue did such a great job in fostering that. But it just seems like to me there's negativity around the league. The league wasn't as big a deal back then. Mike, it seemed more real to me. And I'm not, I don't remember my father's NFL, but it seemed more real to me.
Well, look, you know, there are more negative things. And I think part of that is because with the increased scrutiny, with the increased media attention, you're going to see the warts a little bit more. But I'm not denying that there are a lot of problems off the field in the NFL. But when you talk about the product as a whole, and you talk about fans going to the games and starting a season feeling like, hey, my team's got a shot to at least make the postseason, I think it's more open to more fans than it has ever been before.
All right, that takes us to one thing that has changed the game, and that, of course, is free agency. So has free agency made the game better or worse? I'm going to go first, too, because I'm already talking. I think free agency has made the game worse. The good thing about free agency is it's always in the news. The NFL's never out of the news. But again, we're contract years. Shouldn't you play the same every year, not when your contract is up? Isn't there something about a kid knowing that Joe Blow is his favorite player and in 10 years or 5 years is still going to be on the same team? I think one thing free agency has changed for the worse is you can't keep up anymore, and I think it's harder to follow teams for a long period of time.
Hey, you know what? Attention spans are divided between so many different things. Hey, you may have also heard about the memo. Computers are out there. There's all kinds of information sources. No, it's a separate memo that came in. Look, as a Steeler fan, I would expect you to long for the bygone days when you could keep all of those all-pro Hall of Famers together. It's not that way anymore. But the great thing is, you name a team in the NFL or most major sports that feel that in the next 3 to 5 years don't have a shot to compete, I think that list is very small.
Well, first of all, the Steelers, we won it 2 years ago, too, my Steelers, my beloved Steelers.
Agreed.
There's more parity than there's ever been. And I'm not sure that's good. Everyone says we want parity. I almost think when there were dominant teams, I thought it was better. That's what I think. You know what Mike thinks. What do you think? It's a 1010 XL shout-out.
Better. They're faster. They're stronger.
I would say it's better.
Worse.
Well, worse. If worse is a word, you know, word for it, I guess.
It's not like the same chemistry they had back 20 years ago.
Back then, it was about rivalries. Like I said, now it's just about money.
Definitely better. I think
with the coming of age of fantasy football has brought about it pretty much a new pastime.
Well, I think the athletes that are here now, they're more showboat. I really don't appreciate that. I think when you score a touchdown, it's your job. Walk away.
It's time for round two on the 1010 XL Showdown presented by Florida Telco.
Welcome back to the program. We've talked about what was better, football then or now. What about Major League Baseball? Better then, better now? I'll start with Bob Bling over here. Better then, better now?
Well, you know what? I'm Bob Bling because my team in baseball has the most bling, the New York Yankees. And when you talk about now, let's go back to about the last dozen years or so. We saw a Yankee dynasty, and you said, you know what? You're not sure if sports are better off without the dynasties. We had that, but yet since 2000, we've had a different team win the World Series every single year, and we've seen small revenue teams do it. We've seen the big revenue teams do it again. To me, it's all about competitive balance, and despite the fact there are a few at the end of the totem pole, like the Tampa Bay Devil Rays in Kansas City, that are so far away from competing, more teams right now feel that they have a legitimate shot to win the World Series than I think they have in a long, long time.
Baseball was better then because we had the great stars then. We had the great players. Baseball was our pastime then. People loved baseball. People embraced the stars of baseball. I don't think they do anymore. I think baseball's got a big-time problem. Number one, there's no African-American athletes in baseball. They're not pursuing baseball. I think baseball's become a very divided sport. I love the day when you as a kid, Mike, and I as a kid, we grew up with our favorite baseball player. I don't think kids do that today. And now part of that is the success of other sports, but I don't get the sense that kids grow up with baseball stars as their heroes anymore. Are there any, is Bonds or A-Rod, are they anybody's hero anymore?
Well, maybe not Bonds and A-Rod, but I think there are heroes out there. If you're in of that mindset, my kid will grow up a baseball fan. He'll have baseball heroes, I have a feeling, because I'll take him to games and I'll watch games with him, and I think that's the way. It has lost a generation of fans because there are so many other things to do. But when you look at the quality of play on the field, we romanticize the past. But if you look at the talent of the players today, I think the players of today, you put them up against the players of 20, 25 years ago, and they'd wipe the floor with them.
And the question we'll never know, none of us will, is the steroid era, and it exists whether people like it or not, how much has it changed the quality of play or the caliber of play in baseball as much as any other sport? That's what we think, then or now. When was baseball better? What do you think? Another 1010 XL shout out.
Baseball, I would say, is better back in the day. I think the money comes into play here, and there's just too much money flying around teams.
Free agency ruined baseball, and plus, I don't care for the DH. DH does not do anything for baseball. It keeps players around that should be retired.
Too corporate, there's too much controversy with steroids and everything else going on.
Juice stadiums, juice balls, juice players.
The pitching is probably not as good as it was, but the hitting's better.
I think if Babe Ruth played today, he wouldn't hit anywhere near 715 home runs because you're not pitching guys 3 days rest. You've got closers, you've got middle relievers, and you've got guys throwing a lot harder, you know, on a consistent basis.
Well, we can't talk about which sport's better without getting to the NBA. Basketball, better then, better now. What do you think?
Well, you know what? You've brought me down. You're so depressing. You think everything's worse nowadays. You finally brought me down to your level.
Because I didn't see the memo. If I'd have seen the memo,
get the
NFL
memo
better
a little bit earlier before we get on set. Clearly, I don't think we're going to disagree here. The NBA today has an image crisis. They've got a superstar crisis. They've got a passion crisis. It's not the same game. This is the one major sport that I look at and I say, you know what? The guys from 20, 30 years ago would beat today's players because they played a superior kind of basketball. Not that they're superior athletes, but they were superior basketball players 20 years ago, and hence their teams were even better.
Completely agree, Mike. Exactly what you said. The athletes are better then, are better now, but they knew how to play then. There was a toughness. There was a basketball savvy that was there then. I don't think it's there now. And I don't know why it's not there. I really think shoe companies and I think camps and I think all these things have gone together to make it a more individual game than ever. And again, we kid about the bling, but truly in that sport, it's about me and it's about what I can do. And I completely agree with you. I think the NBA was a fun sport. It was growing then. And we need, and maybe some players, we'll talk about that in a bit, can help bring it back. All right, we'll take a quick time out. We talked about the sport. Which sport was better? Well, what about which players were better then or now? We'll have it for you after this.